that you and me and Christopher will be a family. And we will never lose each other again. I love you.
Forget it, Tess. You're not taking Trisha's place. Curtis and I won't let it happen.
I'm on your side. If we work together, we can get rid of her.
Where have you been? I called you and you...
I was waiting at the inn for you. You were supposed to meet me for dinner.
Oh, no. I can't believe it. It completely went out of my mind. I was with my father and we were discussing the new job at the company, and it's no excuse. I'm sorry. How could I have forgotten a date with you?
It kind of fits in with the way things have been going lately, don't you think?
Want to tell us, Ava?
I'm not really sure how to say this.
I hope you haven't decided not to take the DNA test, because it's really the only way for us to find out who's the father of your child.
That really won't be necessary. There is no baby.
What?
I tell you, you've lost the child now.
There was never one to lose. The doctor said that that my body was playing tricks on me. It was acting. Pregnant, probably because I was so desperate for your love. See, he said it was a classic example of hysterical pregnancy.
I've got something for you that you're absolutely going to love.
I just walked in.
Well, then I won't keep you too long, I promise. I had one of these for Heather. I got one of these for Heather, and she would play with it for hours on end. In fact, I think one time when Trucker was babysitting for her, it drove him crazy.
I just had to get one for your baby.
What did Leo do this time?
No, it's not Leo. It's he didn't do anything. Could you just flip it for him?
Yeah, of course. I'm sorry.
Can you talk about it?
Yeah, I have to, even though I'd rather just go in bed right now and pull the covers right over my head.
I just came back from a genetic counselor, and they found something wrong with the amniocentesis. It's possible my baby could be born with
It's not a certainty, is it?
No, we have to do some more tests, and a lot depends on the results.
Does Leo know about this?
No, I was with him.
So these tests, if when you take them, they could find that it was maybe a mistake, right? That everything is okay, that there's nothing wrong.
Yeah, that's the thought I'm holding on to. Stacy, I'm scared.
Of course. This has got to be the most frightening.
I always knew that this risk was possible, but I never thought it could happen to me, not to my baby.
No, no one ever thinks that.
No, I couldn't sleep last night. I kept having these horrible thoughts that, you know, maybe it's my fault because I tried to engineer this genetically perfect baby, to try to create a life in such a cold-blooded way.
Shayna, you are the least cold-blooded person in the world. You wanted to share your love with a child. There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, I used to think that, but now I'm beginning to question my motives. Did I just sign up for this only for a perfectly healthy baby and a normal life?
That's what all of us want. It's what we expect. when it doesn't happen, somehow we find the strength to cope.
What if you can't? I used to think I was strong, but I don't think I can deal with this.
So what you're saying is that you're really not pregnant?
Well, the doctor said that since I wanted you to love me so badly, that sometimes a woman's emotions take over her body.
Dr. Daly said that?
He said that sometimes the body could fake symptoms of pregnancy.
Amazing.
What's amazing is how far my subconscious would go for love.
Now what happens? I mean, you're all right, aren't you, Ada?
I'm fine. Oh. I'm a little disappointed, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Strange.
I am.
Even I feel something missing right now.
The doctor said, however, that I could have a real baby anytime I want.
Oh, that's good. Good. Jeremy, could you do me a big favor? Make sure Ava gets home safely, okay? There's something that I really have to do.
The least I can do.
We need to talk about
this. We will. Later. Later. This is really urgent, Ava.
It's obvious the poor man is heartbroken.
I am the one that's heartbroken.
Your ego, maybe, not your heart.
Oh, you are so damn smart.
Just because I proved my point. Actually, Leo did. And it's not for you, never was.
Sweetie, call it Cookie Monster. You're wrong about me, Buck. I'm not here trying to replace anybody. I'm just trying to help somebody that really needs my help and maybe at the same time doing a little healing myself.
Spare me, Mother Teresa. I know you better.
Oh, who the hell are you to judge me? You've never been out for anybody but number one.
Then I'm exactly the right person to judge you, Tess. It takes one to know one.
Don't you know that I don't know who I am anymore? I don't know myself. I spend my days taking care of Chris, reading to him, talking to him. And the days are quiet and they're good, and I think maybe for the first time in my life, I'm happy.
And here I thought you were happy when you were playing Curtis and me against each other. Coming on to me while you were making it with him. You're a schemer through and through, always were, always will be. So don't try to convince me you're into diapers and true love. You're studying that tape like a burglar casing his next heist.
You and Curtis think you have all the answers about me, don't you? Not even asking the right questions.
Look, I know I've been a little wired lately. It has nothing to do with my feelings for you. You don't believe me.
I want to. But after this morning, it's hard. I feel like you're very angry with me.
You explain why you went to see my father. I accepted it.
Did you? If you hadn't walked in and found us this morning, would you have accepted that job at AE?
It's my family's business.
You hate the family business.
Look, you have this theory that I've taken this job because I'm jealous and I want to test you.
And you keep telling me that I'm imagining things, but I know that I'm not crazy, Curtis.
No, you're not crazy. I'm sorry. It's my fault. Look, I've been a coward about the past. I'm afraid to lose you.
Curtis, you are not going to lose me. You keep saying that we can't run away from our mistakes, but I know we can. We have to fight together, you and me, and not let anyone else manipulate us.
I wish I could figure out how.
I know the first step. Marry me.
Of course I want to marry you, Dinah Lee. But you make everything sound so easy.
It is easy. The part about you and me choosing to be together anyway. Curtis, whatever it is that's giving you these bad dreams, let me help you. We can work it out together.
Curtis,
Curtis, don't shut me out. Please tell me what's going on.
Whatever happens, I know that you're going to be strong enough to handle it. You're the bravest and strongest woman I've ever met.
I don't want to talk to anyone
right
now.
I'll send them away.
I need to see Shayna.
Wait, you have to wait.
This can't wait, Stacy.
It's okay, Stacy.
Do you want me to wait in the other room?
No. It's not necessary. Thanks.
We'll talk.
It's about the baby, isn't it? Something's wrong.
Now, I'm not sure that there's anything wrong. I mean, no one is.
But you mean there might be? Look, Shayna, before you had said that there was something that you wanted to ask me to do. What was it?
They need more blood tests. From both of us.
Why? What could they possibly be looking for?
I wasn't completely honest with you the other day in the doctor's office. When I told you that the results of the amniocentesis were routine.
Yeah.
There was an abnormality.
What kind of, what does that mean?
Well, I spoke to a genetic counselor today. Uh-huh. And she said that there's this marker on the baby's chromosomes.
Marker?
Yeah, but if it's on either one of ours, then there's a good chance that there is no birth defect. Oh. But if there isn't, then,
Well, then that just means that this baby has two parents who care very much for him or her, and who are going to do whatever needs to be done.
What about...
This discussion is ended. Shayna, whatever you have to face, whatever, I'm going to be right there with you.
I know you're furious with me. You think you're lost. You hate losing. But you will realize when you simmer down that you actually won. You did. Sit down. You don't love Leo. I know that. You know that. I think Leo knows it, too. What business is it of mine? I care about you as a friend. And I admire you, even when you behave like a spoiled brat. Because even then, you're so creative about it. I mean, I'm totally in awe at your ability to take a hit, land on your feet, and turn it to your advantage. You know, the world is full of wishy-washy people who go around not knowing what they want in life, but you do. Oh, boy, you do. Problem is, you usually want what's wrong for you. Now, I know this is fun and madcap for now, but it could become a serious flaw as the years go by. Because you're sabotaging yourself and your happiness. Eva, I think you know by now that I'm talking from experience. And it's true, I've learned the hard way. I've wasted time and energy on things and people who were wrong for me. And even when I ended up with them, it was a hollow victory. Oh, baby, you'd be lost on Leo. He's a nice enough fellow, but he's so conservative. You'll be bored with him within a month. What you need is a man who appreciates your imagination and your fire. That's what you need.
You need to take a long trip somewhere, very, very far away. Possibly back to that monastery in Tibet, if it's still there. Because if you stay in my face, I will make your life miserable. You think I've been creative so far? Well, you will see nothing yet. My revenge on you will be slow, sweet, and dazzling. And when I am through with you, you will never butt into anybody else's life again. Hunter, I am going to bring you to your knees.
I can't wait.
Curtis, did I really do something so terrible asking you to marry me?
You didn't do anything terrible.
Well, then, don't you think it's a little rude not to answer a lady when she proposes to you? I mean, you've always been such a gentleman. Is it because I jumped the gun and proposed first? Maybe the way that I proposed was a turnoff. Too abrupt, not romantic enough. I mean, sure, women are always complaining about that. Why shouldn't men? That's fair. That's cool. I can, tell you what. I withdraw my offer. It's gone. Yep, it's gone. I'm gonna try something else. Curtis, from the very first moment that I saw you, I knew you were the man for me. Well, no, maybe not from the first moment, but I mean, actually, I thought you were a serial killer, but with good reason. I mean, you nearly scared me half to death. That's why I had to bring you out of the cabin. I'm so sorry. But then you came back. You were so cute. You had chills and a fever, and you were sick, and I had to take care of you and keep you warm with my own body heat, and that's when I knew that I'd be yours forever. Oops. Guess I forgot the ring. I'm a little nervous. It's my first time. It's my first time with this, anyway. I guess what I'm really trying to say is that, I really love you. And you would make me very happy if you would be my husband.
I love you, you sweet, crazy lady, very, very, very much.
So, is that a yes? I don't know why you're coming after me like this. It seems to me that we're all in the same boat, you and Curtis and me. We've all got something on each other. And that's the best reason I can think of to stay out of each other's way. You know, live and let live.
Except that people don't live all that long when they get mixed up with you, Tess.
I didn't murder anybody. Curtis did. And you're the one who used Tricia to worm your way into this house without telling Trucker that you were his brother. What are you trying to do? Force me to go public with what I know?
I don't have much to worry about. You wouldn't want your late husband's family to find out where you are.
Like I said, it's a draw. What would it hurt for you to bide your time a little longer, huh? I mean, come on, you could stay here and keep an eye on things and just make sure that nothing, that I don't do anything to your little brother and your nephew.
It'll never get that far.
Look, Buck, I was being straight with you before when I said that all I wanted to do was be Chris's nanny and make a home for his father and him. Come on, you have to admit that this was a sadder house before I came into it.
There's something about you, Tess. There's no denying that.
Thank you.
Don't thank me. I'm not your friend. Your charm is your stock and trade, and you use it like a pro. Watching you wheel and deal in Kuwait was quite a revelation. But those days are over.
What are you going to do?
Go to Trucker if I have to. Lay out the whole story for him. Even if it means I lose my brother.
You're not going to do that, Buck. You're not going to do that because you know if you do, you're going to cost Curtis his freedom. And maybe even his life.
Chance to give you a family. So true.